Boom!
Yo, what's going on, guys and girls? And welcome back! Oh, my mate's back! Hey!
Been growing a beard, haven't I?
Yeah, it's been busy away growing a beard. Seems like the terrible two summers back. I'm Shakademus, he's Pliers, as you know. And we're going to do a UFC 228 predictions of what's coming up. So.
For the three main fights, not the whole card in itself.
No, yeah, it's a big card, and they end up being two big long videos. But the first fight is Zabit versus Brendan Davis. Now, Zabit's got a second name, which we'll obviously put down here. But we're not going to murder the pronunciation. And so Brendan Davis versus Zabit.
To be honest, I don't know who Brendan Davis is.
No, neither of us do.
He's 9-4. I'm assuming he's a journeyman, if you like. Hopefully he surprises us, puts up a good fight. So
was
I've never seen him to be challenged, because his last fight was brilliant.
Yeah, he looked amazing.
Warrior.
For that division as well, for the division they're in, that absolutely was. 145 and he's 6. Have a look at the stats quickly. He's what in height? 73 inches, which is about 6'1", 6'2"?
Yeah, he's 6'1", I think.
Yeah, and full 145 pounds.
The actual, but
yeah, that's absolutely nuts, isn't it? He towers above all the other 145.
He's similar to James Vick. James Vick was 6'+.
Yes, good call. So really, it's going to be a tough prediction. I think Zabit's going to climb the ladder slowly and surely, but it's not fair on Brendan Davis to kind of.
I'm going to put a bit of faith in Zabit and say a first round finish.
Yeah,
from what I've seen of him, he's brilliant. And if this dude, like, no disrespect, obviously the records don't mean nothing, but if he's 9-4 and I've never heard of him, and we would have probably heard of him if he had done something good. But
it's probably one of those you'd be surprised. You'd have seen him in a fight somewhere and gone, shit. But I'm with you, I'm going to go for Zabit to win within one or two. You know, it'd be unfair to give.
I wouldn't mind seeing Zabit submit someone.
Be interesting.
Do you know what I mean? Bear in mind he's only ranked 15, come up as like an all rounder, not just like a knockout technical.
That's true.
Corner, he's just
The height isn't a lot, there's only 3 inches in height now. Brendan Davis is quite a big flyweight as well, featherweight, sorry. You know, there's only 3 inches in height between them, which is, noticeable, but it's not.
It does make a big difference, I would say, because Chad Mendes is 5'6" and Conor's 5'9", so that's a 3-inch difference.
And you can see it.
Yeah, you can genuinely
see it. So we're both going to go Zabit.
Zabit!
I'm going to go within two. You're going to go in one?
I think it's going to be quite a quick fight.
Yeah.
Yeah, I can either see a quick takedown, quick submission, or TKO.
Sweet.
Landing too many and the ref won't like it.
Yeah, I think Zabit would defeat him. I'm going to go with a flying knee. I think it'll be something special. Why not in the second round?
See, he's quite, he can do it.
Yeah. Why not? Something special that'll make you stand up and go, whoa, shit.
But yeah, Nico and Valentina.
Which is a co-main event, and it's for the women's flyweight title, which is
the second ever flyweight title match.
Yeah, and you know, for the UFC's newest division, which is.
Which was needed.
Yeah, I think so.
Hell of a need.
I still think there's a couple more divisions needed within MMA. I think they could shuffle it up a bit. There definitely could be one in 155, 165.
We might even do a separate talk just about the divisions and how we personally think they should be and the weights and all that jazz.
And then meet in the middle and disagree still anyway. But I like Valentina Shevchenko. I think she's absolute beast.
When I first heard the matchup, I honestly thought ridiculously mismatched. Valentina's going to destroy her. But I've done a little bit of digging on this Nico. She ain't no mother.
No, she seems like a little brawler.
Her amateur fights are brilliant. No one would agree to fight her because she was finishing girls too quick.
Yep.
Her submission game is brilliant, which could come into play in the fight. I could see Valentina, if it's the same as, I don't know if you've seen Valentina's debut for the 125.
Yes.
It's complete domination, but the ref lost his job over it because of how much he let someone get hurt.
Yeah, he should have stopped it way sooner.
I imagined if that was Nico on the bottom in that fight, she would be going for attacks, submissions and that lot. Whereas, was it Raquel Pennington she fought?
No, it wasn't Pennington.
I'm sure it was a Raquel or a something like
I can't
that.
Remember who it was in her last fight.
We'll put who it was up.
Yeah.
It was almost like she just kept trying to get up.
Yeah.
It wasn't like she's going to think, right, I'm on my back. Whereas I can see Nico going for guillotines and more anything she can.
Yeah.
About triangles, anything. Do you know what I mean? So I imagine that fight. I still think Valentina's going to win.
Yeah.
But I think Nico's going to surprise people. I think maybe a third round or a fourth rounder or fourth round finish for Valentina. And I can't see Nico giving up.
Yeah, that's fair. Yeah, I'm with you on that. I think she seems like a little pit bull. You know what I mean? Look, she's a like proper fighter. She seems made of that Jessica Andrade material where it's just Carla Esparza or something. From the Vision.
Carla B.
She seems like a proper fighter, but coming down in weight as well. Valentina's carrying that advantage of being the bigger girl naturally.
Well, no, you say that, but technically it's not, because Valentina never really cut weight for 135.
She
was always fighting. If you look at some of her fights, like when she fought Holly Holm, the size difference in that octagon was phenomenal, because Valentina don't balloon up after she's
Yeah, that's true.
Whereas for the 25, she actually gets to cut a bit of weight in and then go back up to her, say, natural 138 or whatever it is.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Yeah. And same for Nico.
I'm with you. I think it'd be a third round stoppage. I think the ref will stop it.
Third or fourth. Yeah. It's going to be a bloody fight. Because Valentina's... She's got such a multi-background that if she isn't in punching range, she's just elbow after elbow. Yep. As soon as she gets full mount, she rains them down.
Bang, bang, bang.
I can see it being a... And Nico cuts easy.
Yeah.
She was bloodied up when she won the belt off Roxy.
Yeah, that's true.
And Roxy is nowhere near the striker that Valentina is. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Roxy's a brilliant submission artist, and she nearly did finish Nico with that armbar, to be fair.
It's true,
just indeed. Got out of it, so that shows that Nico's hot.
But I think we're both set with Valentina on this one.
100%.
Yeah.
100%.
So the main event.
Good luck, Nico. I almost want to be proven wrong, but Valentina's got it.
Love an underdog. So it's obviously our boy Darren Till against the champion Tyrone Woodley.
Till the Gorilla. This is going to be what I want and what I think.
Yeah, I'm with you on that. Like, I think Till will win, and I want him to win. But I know how dangerous Woodley is. I know you don't sleep on Tyrone Woodley. You just do not sleep on Tyrone Woodley. I like Tyrone.
I want Till to win so much. Do you know what I mean?
He's
brought one up the road from us.
Yeah.
I mean, I want Till to win.
100%. Come on, Darren Till.
But
shit.
He ain't gonna. I just can't see it. I honestly think he's gonna go five rounds and he's gonna win decision. It is gonna be a borderline replica of the Wonderboy fights, and like not so much boring. I don't think it's going to be a boring fight whatsoever.
More like Woodley, Wonderboy 1.
Like with Woodley, it's hard to put, but he's not all-rounded. He's not an all-rounded fighter, but his overhand right and his double leg takedown is 100%.
Yes,
it's 100%. So as long as he keeps faking takedowns and throwing the overhand and keep faking the overhand and taking him down, Darren's going to get frustrated, it's going to become a wrestling match, and it's going to... I can see Darren getting burnt out.
Do you know what belt Darren is in Jiu-Jitsu? Because he's been in Brazil for...
He's very good.
Yeah.
Don't sleep on his...
On his ground game, yeah.
But Darren, he's just so powerful.
He's dangerous, isn't he? He's a beast.
You probably tell from all our other videos, I don't like him.
I'm not the biggest fan.
His personality, he plays the victim card a lot. He doesn't try to connect with fans and all that jazz, but he's an animal.
He's an animal, mate. I can't deny that.
We'll put the picture up of them next to each other. Compare their thighs.
Yeah.
Look at their legs. Fairview's Till's got a bit of height on him and he's going to come in heavier.
Yeah.
And I know he balloons up to like 203 or
whatever. Yeah. But Woodley walks out 2:02, though, doesn't he, says?
Yeah, well, when he squared off with Bisping, he was 2:04, was it? Yeah. Woodley, he says, what are you at the moment?
Yeah.
I don't know what to say. But Woodley's...
So,
Woodley's
you think Woodley's going to win?
Oh, I hate to say it, but I almost want to say I know.
I think Till's going to win.
I
think he's going to be too powerful for him. I know that sounds silly in regards to what would for what Woodley is.
He's a Wonder Boy 2.0. I think comes to, he's got the same skill, but he's got that.
Yeah, I think and I don't think he's going to not go forward. That's where Wonder Boy was on the back foot, and they were both kind of it got come to a chess match, didn't it? Where you throw off, or you throw off.
You think Darren will?
I've got a sneaky feeling. I don't think he's going to be scared of his takedown.
See, I do.
I don't. I think. I've got a sneaky feeling. Darren Till's surprisingly dangerous on the back.
Maybe in the first, it closed the distance and whatnot. Who's Wonderboy picks him up and Woodley picks him up and slams him, and Till feels that power on top of him. Because bearing in mind, Till's used to being the dominant.
Yeah.
Power, height, yeah. Strength, everything when it comes to a fight. He's got Tyrone covered on height and probably a little bit of weight.
First clinch is going to be crucial, isn't it?
The first takedown Tyrone gets in the first, which I reckon will.
Who knows? He might not get it.
Then the next.
Not could be.
The next rounds. Till's going to be frustrated and stay on the back foot. Keep trying.
Do you think that, from what you've seen of Till's personality, does it strike you as that kind of a guy, or what makes you think that he's not professional enough to do?
From what I've seen, it's a while ago. It was in 2013. Can you remember his debut? I can't remember the dude's name. That's what's really bugging me.
Okay,
we'll put it up. We'll definitely put it here if you used to have a quick look.
Or somewhere.
But mate, he comes in and he just runs at matey, lands an overhand right. By the time matey's even hit the floor, he's like spun and he's on the back of matey.
Yes.
He had the
lime green shorts on that fight. There was some really, really unique cut.
I hope Till wins.
I'm with you.
But I think Woodley's got it. I don't think it finished Till. Till's too much. Do you know what I mean? Maybe a TKO, but I don't reckon. Five rounds, Wonderboy. Woodley wins from maybe a split decision or a unanimous decision. Just from the takedowns and the dominance and being on top and. Till not being able to get up and whatnot.
Yeah, I think Till keeps him at range. I think Till's a bit longer than Lawler. I don't think Woodley didn't have as good. What, he covered the ground twice in the two Wonderboy fights that I can think of? In the two together. Where he covered the ground and swung that big overhand right.
Yeah, he did drop Wonderboy.
I think Till's a bit quicker than Wonderboy. I think Till showed that in his fight against Wonderboy. So I just genuinely thought. I think Till's. It's like a train.
I'd say Wonderboy's a little bit quicker, but Wonderboy's got a tendency for point shots. Do you know what I mean? Whereas Till, almost everything he lands has got bad intentions. Whereas Wonderboy he would throw the leg out there to keep him away and whatnot. Whereas I don't see Darren as that. I see Darren as throwing has got a bit of a meaning
behind it. Yeah, but I think he'd be a bit too long for Woodley. I think it'd be a. I think Till will knock him out in a second. I think he'll stop him. I've got a sneaky feeling we're going to see a turn in the guard in that division.
I think Tyrone.
I'm going to go down Till.
Loser does a forfeit. Leave it down below. Peace.
Gay!